This video is going to be about solving logarithmic equations. And once again, we're going to use that conversion formula that we have for going from logarithms to exponential form. Remember, that was the log base b of a equals x is the same as b to the x equals a. So let's try some of these. What if I start out with the log base 3 of x equals 2. Okay, so I'm going to convert that to 3, that was my base, raised to the exponent 2 equals x. Well, that means 3 squared, so 3 squared is 9, so x must be 9. Okay? Let's do the log of 1,000. The log of 1,000 equals x. You remember, if you don't see a base, the base is 10. So that means I'm going to have 10 to the x power equals 1,000. Anytime I've got 10 raised to some number, to some power, I can look at what it equals, like this 1,000. After the 1, count how many zeros I have, and that will be my answer. So x equals 1, 2, 3. Okay? So if you're comfortable with that, let's try one where I'm looking for the base, the log base b of 8 equals 3. Okay, so I'm going to take the base, the b, raise it to the third power, and that equals 8. So what number raised to the third power is 8? Well, that number is 2. 2 to the third power is 8. So b equals 2. Okay, so these are kind of basic. Let's get on to some a little more sophisticated. So what if I have log base 6 of negative 2x equals 3? Now the whole trick here is just do the same thing we've been doing all along, okay? I know this looks confusing, but it's really not that hard. So I'm going to take that base, which is 6, raise it to the third power, 6 to the third power, equals this argument in here, negative 2x. So let's see what happens. 6 to the third power is 216. If you don't have that memorized, which you might be a good idea since it's nice to memorize the cubes, you can always use your calculator for that. So 216 equals negative 2x, and that will just solve this. That just means dividing both sides by negative 2. And we're going to find that x equals 216 divided by negative 2 is negative 108. Okay? Okay, so that wasn't that bad. Let's try this. The log base 3 of x plus 12 equals 2. Keep doing the same procedure. 3 raised to the second power, or 3 squared, equals x plus 12. 3 squared is 9, so 9 equals x plus 12. If I subtract 12 from both sides, I'm going to find out that x is negative 3. Here's one with an exponent. The log base 4 of 8 raised to the x equals 3. Okay, same procedure. 4 raised to the third power equals 8 to the x. Okay, so what is 4 to the third power? Well, 4 squared is 16, and 4 times 16 is 64. So 64 equals 8 raised to some power, raised to the x. Well, 64, 8 squared is 64. So x must equal 2. Okay? And now let's do some with fractions. So how about the log base 4 of 1 over 16 equals x. So that means that 4 raised to the x power equals 1 over 16. So if we've got 4 raised to some power is 1 over 16, let's see what we can do with this 16. Well, 16 is 4 squared, so let's change that. 4 to the x equals 1 over 4 squared. And now I want both these sides to look the same as much as possible. So I'm going to take that 4 squared, move it into the numerator. I'll just change the 2 exponent to a negative 2. So I'm going to get 4 to the x equals 4 to the negative 2. So that must mean that x equals negative 2. Okay. And I think I have one more here. Let's take the log base 1/2 of 8 equals x. So I want to take 1/2, I want to take that base, raise it to the x power, and I'm going to say that equals 8. Okay, so let's deal with this 1/2 to the x power first. Well, 1 to the x is just 1, and 2 to the x is 2 to the x. And that equals 8. Since I'm dealing with a 2, I want to convert this 8 into something with a 2, and that's going to be 2 to the third. So 1 over 2 to the x equals 2 to the third. Since I've got an x in my denominator, on the left side of the equation, I'm going to try to get the right side of the equation to also have a denominator. So I'll have 1 over 2 to the x equals, I'm going to take this 2 to the third and make it 1 over 2 to the negative 3. And now if 1 over 2 to the x equals 1 over 2 to the negative 3, then x must equal negative 3. Okay? So look, for every one of these, it was the same basic approach. We use this general concept of converting from logarithmic form to exponential form. We go from log base b of a equals x to b to the x equals a. And then we just take the equation that we have, plug in the b's, the a's, and the x's, wherever they belong, and then solve for what you've for your unknown. Okay? So that's it. Take care. See you next time.